this song. There's so many different beliefs in the world today, but only one belief will get you over the top. And we just sung about that belief. His birth, his death, his resurrection. The blessed hope that he's coming back again. How many of you look longing for his return? I know I am. I'd like him to come back before I finish paying my mortgage. They can keep my cars, credit card bills, all that kind of stuff. They can have it. Give it to the Antichrist. I don't want it. I just want to be where he's at, you know? I just want to hear them words, thy good and thy faithful servant. Welcome into the joy of the Lord. All the other things, all the other trophies that we get in life, they can be set aside as long as we hear them words from the Lord. I'm longing for them words. I'm longing to see you there as well. Today the Lord wants you to be encouraged today. He wants you to be strengthened in your body and your lives. Years and years ago, my wife doesn't think so, but I take total responsibility for Joel Osteen's prosperity in his ministry. That's on some advice I gave him. Met Joel Osteen and I gave him some advice, which I know is the catalyst for the reason why he's got such a great church today. But he did say to me that his message is a message of encouragement. Now, whether you like him or not, that's not the point here. He felt the people needed to be encouraged. There's enough going on in the world to discourage us. He wanted to encourage the flock. You know what? We need to encourage each other in the Lord. We need to be encouraged. Sometimes there comes some occasions when you have to encourage yourself. Many times I've had to do it to myself. I could be riding on the home lawnmower, a hot 95 degree day. My body's hurting and my son's out playing around and cutting the grass for dad, and things are going on that day like I didn't really plan. You ever had them days where things are going like you didn't plan? It's within them days where you just have to encourage yourself and say, God, every single thing I do, you see. And you are a rewarder for what we do. Today, Lord Jesus, we come before you. And we sing these songs of praise unto you, and we believe that it turned into a measure of worship. Some of us were able to slip our head inside the inner gate, and some of us stood right at the gate, almost getting in. But God, you're there, and you're here as well. And we pray, God, that this praise and this worship that we offer up to you this morning has been pleasing to you. Matter of fact, I want it to be a statement unto you, God. Matter of fact, God, I want it to be a proclamation of our faith unto you, God, today. And before we go any further, I believe it's appropriate if we sing that chorus one more time. Just the chorus, at least. Rebecca, come up here and sing it again for us. Next to you, that he's coming back for me. Hallelujah. Greet someone in the Lord today. Hallelujah. If you're glad to be here today, give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Well, there may be more than these two. There may be more. If there is, I didn't mean to miss you. I just wasn't told about it. I know we have two birthdays today. One's not here. Joy Porter's not here. But I do see Juliet in the back. Today's her birthday. Raise your hand, Juliet. Then give her a nice hand clap for her birthday. Happy birthday, Juliet. It's good to see you here today, Don. Tomorrow is Josiah Young, Devana's young son's birthday tomorrow. The reason why I know that is he made sure I knew that today. He came and told me about it. Tomorrow's my birthday. I turn 11 tomorrow. I just want you to know that. So if y'all see little Josiah Young later at the service, just tell him happy birthday. He's pumped up about his birthday. Amaris' birthday tomorrow as well. Anyway. Cherish years, they go away quick. Today, before we take up the offering, before we do, guys, we'd like to go ahead and acknowledge our new visitor. Do we have any new visitors in the house today? Any new visitors? Just raise your hand if you're new. I'm looking around. I don't see any new ones here. We're all over. Well, give yourself a hand clap today for being faithful to the house of the Lord. And then at this time, I'd like you to prepare your hearts for this morning's offering. The Bible says that we are to be a what's called a joyful giver. When they come by with the offering bag, if you have something to give today, don't have them have to strong arm you to get it. You know what I'm saying? Give it joyfully. It'll come back to you in a bountiful way. Father God, in Jesus' name, we pray your blessings upon the offering this morning. Your tithes and your offerings above them. We pray, dear God, that you will bless it and multiply it for your kingdom and for your purposes. And that, God, you will also provide for us all we have need of. Bless those that can give this morning, and even those that cannot give. May you bless them in such a way that they can be a giver in the future. Bless this offering and the time of it, in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you, David. Very nice. Today, before we get into some few announcements, things of that nature, we have a special request. Baby Nathaniel Roberts. Crystal and Nate's son going in Tuesday for surgery. Where's that? Over there in Claremont? Past Claremont?
No, it's in Orange City.
Orange City. Orange County?
Orange. Well, yeah, I guess it's
Orange County. Near Orlando. So he's having surgery tomorrow. Adenoids are coming out. Tubes in the ears are going in. You know, quite of an in-depth process for a little boy and his age. And you know how the parents are going to be filling out in the waiting room. We best put ourselves in their shoes. I told her she was kind of hesitant about even having him here today, not wanting him to get sick right before surgery, you know? So, but she knows the importance of prayer. So I like Crystal to bring baby Nate up here. And I got three women in mind. We're all gonna participate by stretching our hands, but I got three women in mind. I'd like to have my wife, Miss Carmen, and Miss Marilee come up here. And I'd like you to lay your hands on baby Nate, if you will. I've got some oil here. I want y'all, Millie, make sure everybody has some oil in their hands here. I want you to stretch your hands in the congregation towards baby Nate. He's a precious child. I can guarantee you he's going to probably be the praise leader of the Church of the Lord Terry's in the future. He's always wanting to grab a microphone up here. So the devil will love nothing more than to snuff him out. You know that? He's been sick way too much. It's time for God to really heal him and bless him. So Carmen, why don't y'all just start beginning to pray, and we'll just pray with you. Father God, in Jesus' name, as we raise our hands and place our hands and anoint baby Nate with oil, God, we declare by our faith in Jesus Christ that by his stripes, God, Nate is healed this morning. He is delivered. He is set free of whatever is causing him to get sick, God. We pray, God, that if he does have to go through this procedure, God, we pray that you would guide the surgeon's hand, God. That you, the ultimate physician, will be there with this physician, God. And you would guide the procedure. May it come out in flying colors, God. May it be a fast procedure. And may the report that his mom and dad get is that it was fantastic. That he'll heal quickly, God. That it was easy, God. He won't have any issue with anesthesia. He will recover with no pain, God. God, we will get a report back from the hospital and from Nathan and Crystal that it was a successful procedure. But God, we pray right now in Jesus' name that you can abort that procedure right here this day. You can heal him right now this day, God. They can go into prepping for this procedure and don't even have to do it, God. We believe a prayer of faith will rise up those that are sick, God. So we pray in Jesus' name, God, that your stripes, God, will be applied to his body and that, God, by them, he is now healed and set free. For this we pray, God, in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Why don't you give him a hand clap for the victory over the God? No worries whatsoever. No worries. Today at this time, I'd like Steve Parrish to come here. He's going to give an announcement about today's nursing home ministry and also a plug for the men's group or something.
I'm thinking earlier when we were singing this song, we believe. And, God has given each one of us a task, is to reach out and touch others and spread the word of God. And as I was reading and reading Genesis the other day, I was noticing as he was giving, talking about the line of who begot whom and so on and so on. And then you say, we were reading this one lived this many years and then he died. And then another one lived this many years and he died. And another one lived this many years and he died. Then it gets to one that said this one lived this many years and it doesn't say that he died.
Yes, that's right.
Wouldn't it be awesome to be taken up doing what God has called each one of us to do?
Yes.
Right in the midst of what we're supposed to be doing, that we don't die, that he just takes us up. So this is what we're doing with this nursing home ministry. We want to be doing what God has called us to do. Again, whatever it is that you've been called to do. But those, again, as many people that have asked me about being a part of this, about part of this ministry. Today we're going over at 1:30, Cypress Cove, assisted living facility. I don't like to call it really just a nursing home. It's an assisted living facility. So again, for whatever it is that you're called to do, I don't know why the Lord just placed this on my heart to say this, but to whatever it is that you are called to do, get busy with your ministry. Time is short.
Yes.
Time is short. So again, those that are wanting to go over, like I said, we're going to meet back here at the church at 1, and we're, for those that need a ride, I got enough room that I can give somebody a ride. But we encourage for whomever that want to be a part of it, come on, you don't have to be a member of the church to be a part of it. Anybody that wants to be a part of it, come on, be a part of it. Also, take a breath, next door, subject. Fishing trip, coming up October 3rd. We have tickets that are available right now. There is 40 tickets, $55 per ticket. Both men and women can go. So it's not just men, $55 per ticket. And Alan put up a little thing in the back there on our board, on the men board. We have the thing for the fishing trip, but he also puts like some identification of different fish that we catch. So again, if you want to go, see me. I have tickets. It's a first come, first serve basis. So the ticket's going to be gone real quickly. All right?
Thank you, Steve. Bowman was sharing with me earlier. Mark Jackson films the service. He gives them to Steve Bowman, and Steve Bowman, in turn, because Rachel showed him how to do it, she with the orchestrator the thing, he puts them onto a YouTube channel. On our website, he will give you on our website a link. If you tap on that link, you can go to any sermon you want to see online, okay? So in the future, when you go on our website, go to the sermon section, click on a link, and you can go right into it and pick out that sermon and see the sermon, okay?
Sunday school as well.
What's that?
Sunday school as well.
Sunday school as well. He's teaching in Sunday school on that link too. You can see baptism services. Oh, excuse me. Let's talk about that right now. He was sharing with me that the concern he has, and this is where we have to do a little better job as a church, is when it comes to putting on the internet things that have children in it, whether it be water baptism or whether it be the children's play, we're going to start needing y'all to start giving us a signing off a waiver, a disclaimer, letting us to put your child on there. On the site, because sometimes you get in trouble for that kind of stuff. So if you have no problem with having your child on our website, maybe in a Christmas play or something to that regard, then we'll have a waiver for you to fill out and say that's fine. You can do it.
And yes, Bible study too.
Huh?
Wednesday night Bible study.
Bible study you can get online too.
Bible study's online as well.
Steve
okay,
Bowman.
Very good.
Steve Bowman.
Steve Bowman, so you already put a lot of things there, brother. You're a busy young man.
Yeah,
thank you for that.
Wednesday night, for those of you who were here, I don't want to give it to you again. I'm giving it to those that weren't here. Wednesday night, I passed out these little slips of paper. It's a website called www.change.org. It's a website that if you go on the website and you look under Walker's Petition, has a spot on there where you can sign your name. That site there is a petition site that will protect pastors and churches from having to perform same-sex marriages. Yeah. So we encourage you, Ellie, can you pass these out? If you didn't get one of these on Wednesday, you weren't here Wednesday, get one of these, go home, go on the site, sign your name there. They're not coming after you. It's completely legal. And that will keep us pastors and organizations, religious organizations, protected for not having to perform same-sex marriages. You might say, well, I didn't think you had to right now. We're just trying to stay ahead of the game. A lot of these places are trying to get ahead of the game because they're always up in the ante, so we have to continue to stay ahead of the game. Amen? Also, after service, Lorraine and Gil have some goodies on that back table. The table's empty right now, but they will be back there before service ends up. They're going to have some goodies to hand out to you before you leave, free goodies. So please see Lorraine and Gil on that back table before you leave for some goodies. That should do it for the announcement. We do have nursery at this time. Anybody needs nursery, they can feel free to have their child go back to the nursery. But at this time, we're going to do something a little bit different. I've been in my wife's family now almost 22 years. And you would not believe my mother-in-law's face when she first met me. I wasn't the same person then I am today. I had long, real long hair and thought I was cast me out, man. You know, you know what that cast me out was saying is. Well, some things haven't changed. But anyway, the point I'm saying here is that I wasn't saved. I wasn't a righteous serving man at all. I was pretty much lost in my transgressions and sins. And Millie, I met my wife at a wedding. She said, call me on this number and we'll talk. Well, she tried to trick me. She gave me her mother's number. Thinking that her mother would just say, ain't not gonna happen, you know. Well, long story short, I met her mother at the home one day. We had a nice little talk, and her mother felt at peace about me and felt out that God had ordained this union, believe it or not. Have you ever heard the scripture that says, don't be unequally yoked? But God had told her, gave her a peace about it, and you know, 22 years later, we're married, and I'm saved, and pastoring a church, and there used to be a show called Fathers Knows Best. Well, in this case, mothers knew best. She knew. But in all the years, she's been a missionary. Matter of fact, she was the first person that ever really made me afraid of the Holy Ghost. She received the Holy Ghost in a powerful way just 3 feet away from me. And I didn't know how to act, you know? I mean, it was a powerful display, but I also show how powerful God was through her. And the only thing that's kept her and I from being even closer is the language barrier. She speaks predominantly Spanish, I speak all English, and it makes it tough for us to communicate, but she loves God, and she's been a missionary to several different countries, and after 22 years, I'm gonna finally give her a chance to share what's on her heart. My wife's gonna interpret for her this morning, but she said she had a word from God, and told my wife last week, I think I need to come and share this word if your husband would allow it. You know what I respect about my mother-in-law? She didn't just assume it. She goes, if your husband feels that God would let that happen, I'd like to come share that word. There's a message there for all of us on that. To want God's will, not our own. So, Naomi Perez, come up and share what God has for us today. I asked her, I said, you okay? She goes, oh, I feel okay. But it's a little high today. What was her number today? She said her numbers were 181 over 110. But God's going to use her right now in a mighty way.
Amen. Gloria a Jesús.
Glory to God.
Gloria a Dios.
Glory to God.
Alaba a Dios. Dios está aquí.
Praise the Lord. He's here.
Dios le bendiga, hermano.
God bless you, brothers.
Dios le bendiga más.
God bless you more.
Es un privilegio de parte de Dios.
It's a privilege from God.
Estar aquí con ustedes.
To be here with you today.
Gloria a Jesús. Gloria al nombre del Señor.
Praise the Lord.
Aleluya.
Hallelujah.
Me siento un poco nerviosa.
I feel a little bit nervous today.
Porque yo no hablo inglés y ustedes no entienden español.
Because I don't speak English and you don't understand Spanish.
Gloria a Jesús. Aleluya. Milly va a ser mi intérprete.
I will be her interpreter.
Pero cuando el coro cantaba,
but when the worship sang,
le dije a Dios, Señor, estoy nerviosa.
Lord, I'm nervous.
No sé qué hacer.
I don't know what to do.
Dios me habló ahí y me dijo, tú, Milly, no vas a ser la intérprete. El intérprete voy a ser yo que voy a hablar. Gloria
God
a Dios.
God spoke to her and told her that I will not be their interpreter.
Alabado
He
Dios.
Will be their interpreter.
Aleluya.
That will speak.
Yo no estoy aquí por casualidad.
I'm not here by casualty.
Gloria a Jesús. Aleluya. Gloria a Dios. Al Señor le plació que yo estuviera aquí en esta mañana.
God was pleased that he, that she would be here this morning.
De Dios, aleluya.
Glory to God.
A través de sueño,
through dreams.
Dios me ha confirmado este día de hoy este mensaje.
God has confirmed this day to me and this message.
Gloria a Dios. No voy a coger mucho tiempo.
I will not take a lot of time.
Solo el que Dios me permita.
Only what God permits me to
Gloria
do.
A Dios, porque yo sé, Gloria a Jesús, la regla, las leyes de aquí, Gloria a Dios.
Because I know the time and the rules from here.
Gloria al Señor, pero allá arriba hay uno que dirige este pueblo, Gloria a Jesús, alabado sea el nombre de Dios, aleluya. Y él es el que va a decirle el tiempo que vamos a estar aquí. Gloria a Dios.
The one that's going to say the time that
Gloria
we're going
a Dios.
To be here.
Él es el que va a poner en mi boca la palabra que tú quieres oír, que tú necesitas oír en esta mañana. Gloria
he
al nombre del Señor.
He is going to put the words that you need to hear and the words that you need to listen to this morning.
Porque Dios es real y Dios
Because
ama
God
a este
is real
pueblo.
And he loves his people.
Gloria a Jesús.
Glory to God.
Y para la porción de la palabra en esta mañana,
for the portion of the word today,
ustedes busquen a Revelation.
You're going to get Revelation.
Chapter 4.
Verse 1. She'll read it in Spanish, I'll read it in English. Okay, she wants me to read it for her. Revelations, chapter 4, starting in verse 1. Hasta dónde? Okay, just read verse 1. After this I looked, and there before me was a door standing open in heaven. And the voice I had first heard speaking to me like a trumpet said, Come up here, and I will show you what must take place after this.
Gracias, Dios. Gracias, Padre.
Thank you, Jesus. In your hands I am.
Conforme a tu me des, yo doy a este pueblo.
Whatever you shall give me, I will give your people. In the name of Jesus. Amen.
Gloria a Dios. Aleluya.
Aleluya.
Aleluya. Vive Jesús.
Live the Lord.
Estamos viviendo en los días más difíciles. Gloria al Señor.
We're living in the most difficult times
de la historia.
Of the history.
Gloria a Jesús. Si usted ve alrededor del mundo violencia, crimen, maldad.
If you look around the world, you see violence, you see crime, and you see evil.
Gloria a Jesús.
Glory
la
to God.
La gente anda como loco por la calle.
The people walk around like crazy people
la
on
gente,
the streets.
La gente va sin fe, sin Dios, sin salvación.
The people are without faith, without God, and without salvation.
Y estamos viviendo en un mundo
and we're living in a world
que apesta infierno.
That stinks like hell.
Yes. Gloria a Jesús. Apesta infierno porque todo lo que vemos, gloria a Dios.
It stinks like hell because everything that we see,
todo, everything, está contaminado
con
violencia,
with violence,
con crimen,
with crimes,
con maldad,
with evilness,
con pecado,
with sin.
La gente anda, gloria a Dios.
The people walk
sin Dios en su corazón,
without
gloria
God
a Jesús.
In their
alabado Dios.
Glory
alabado
to God.
Dios.
Praise the Lord.
Pero Dios en su misericordia,
but God in his mercy,
gloria al nombre al Señor, está cuidando de un pueblo que tiene aquí en esta tierra.
He is taking care of his people in this land. That is you and I.
Eres tú y yo, gloria al Señor.
It's you and it's I.
Un pueblo, gloria al nombre del Señor, que tiene que estar preparado.
That has to be ready.
Porque Cristo viene ya.
Because Jesus is coming soon.
Alabado Dios.
Praise the Lord.
Y el mundo no tiene a Cristo.
And the world does not have God.
Pero tú y yo tenemos un Cristo vivo. Gloria
but you and I have a Jesus that's alive.
Que ha prometido.
That has promised.
Librarnos. De la hora de la prueba que va a venir sobre de los habitantes de la tierra.
For the time of the persecution that's going to come over the inhabitants of the earth.
Gloria a Jesús.
Glory to God.
He leído este libro de Revelación.
I have read the book of Revelation.
Milly me llamó a mi casa.
I called her at home.
Me dijo, yo quiero que tú me des un estudio acerca de Revelación.
I would like for you to give me a study of the Revelation.
Yo le dije, un estudio no se da en un día.
A study, she told me, a study I can't give in a day of Revelation.
No en un día.
I can't do it in one
se
day.
Coge mucho tiempo.
It takes a lot of time.
Porque este es el libro.
Because this is the book.
Gloria al Señor, que el Señor dejó preparado para
that
que la iglesia
God
de Dios
prepared for the church
lo lea.
Of God will read it.
Gloria al Señor, lo estudie.
Will study it.
Lo escudriñe.
Will take it to heart.
Y lo viva.
And will live it.
Porque aquí Dios escribió todo lo que va a pasar.
Because
Gloria
in that book, Jesus wrote everything that will happen.
Después que la iglesia se vaya al cielo.
After the church leaves to God, with God.
Ahora yo hago una pregunta.
Now I make a question.
¿Tú estás preparado?
Are you ready?
Yes, Lord.
¿Tú estás preparado?
Are you ready?
Para que si Cristo viene hoy,
if God Jesus comes today,
porque Cristo puede venir hoy,
because he can come today,
no mañana,
not tomorrow,
no de aquí a 10 años,
hoy, not here in 10 years, today, are you ready to go with Jesus Christ today if he comes today?
Jesús. Alabado Dios.
Praise the Lord.
Santo el Señor.
Holy is God.
Los primeros tres capítulos,
the first three chapters
de
Revelación,
hablan
talks
de las cartas que Dios escribió,
about the letters that God wrote,
Gloria al Señor, en aquel tiempo,
in the time,
siete cartas,
seven letters,
siete iglesias,
seven churches,
Gloria al Señor, que representa la iglesia de todos los tiempos.
That represents the church of every time.
Como Dios se le reveló, gloria a Dios.
How God revealed himself.
A Juan el teólogo.
John the theologist.
Para que Juan escribiera,
for
gloria
John
al Señor, a la iglesia.
To write the letters to the church.
Las iglesias son representadas por siete estrellas.
The churches are represented by seven stars.
Que son los pastores, el ángel de la iglesia.
That are the pastors, the angels of the church.
Siete candeleros.
Seven candle holders.
Que son las siete iglesias de aquel.
That are the seven churches of the time.
¿Por qué se le reveló al pastor, al ángel?
Why did the pastor reveal himself to the angel?
¿Por qué no le dio el mensaje al diácono?
Why didn't God give the message to the deacon?
No le dio el mensaje al oficial.
He did not give the message to the official of the church.
No le dio el mensaje a los miembros.
Did not give the message to the members of the church.
Le dio el mensaje al pastor.
He gave the message to the pastor.
Porque él es el responsable.
Because he is responsible.
Gloria a Jesús, de conducir un pueblo al cielo.
That will lead the people to God.
Y no me malinterpreten.
And do not misunderstand me.
Yo no vengo a hablar palabra mía, gloria Señor.
I do not come speak to, I'm not speaking from me. I'm speaking what God has given me.
Él es el responsable de tu vida.
He is responsible, the
gloria
pastor is responsible
Señor,
of
la
your life. Of his life.
Y de todos los que Dios le pone en las manos.
And every person that he puts in his hands.
Porque tiene que predicar la palabra tal cual está, gloria al Señor.
Because he has to preach the word, whoever likes it and whoever does not like it. He has to preach the word of God.
Amen. Gloria a Jesús. Vive Jesús. Y si esa palabra.
And if that word.
No se habla.
Is not spoken of.
Si el pueblo no se interesa en esa palabra,
if his people are not interested in his word,
está perdiendo su tiempo.
You're wasting your time.
Alabado Dios.
Praise the Lord.
Está perdiendo su tiempo.
You're wasting your time.
Y si Cristo viene,
and if God comes,
te quedas.
You stay.
Alabado Dios.
Praise the Lord.
Hay que salir.
You have to go out of the world. You have to come out of the world.
Y apesta infierno.
That smells and stinks like hell.
Gloria al nombre del Señor. Este es un libro.
This is a book.
Que el enemigo.
That the enemy.
No quiere que tú leas.
Does not want that you read.
No quiere que tú estudies.
He does not want you to study the book of Revelation.
Porque Dios le dio el privilegio a la iglesia.
Because God gave the church the privilege.
De que la iglesia sepa.
For the church
Gloria
to know.
Señor, ¿por dónde va a pasar este mundo que apesta infierno si no viene a Cristo y se convierte a él? Gloria
Where
Jesus.
The world is going to go through if the church does not repent? He does not want the people of God to know where the he's going to take the world, so the people will not repent.
Gloria a Dios por ese privilegio.
I thank God for that privilege.
El enemigo no quiere que tú oigas esto.
The enemy does not want you to listen to what
él
she's
pelea,
saying.
Él busca por donde tú
he fights,
no
he will look, and he will not give you an interest in the book.
Pero todo lo que está pasando,
but everything that is happening,
todo lo que está aconteciendo,
everything that is occurring,
Señor, está escrito.
It's written.
El mundo se sorprende de lo que está pasando hoy en día con los homosexuales.
The world is surprised of what's going on with the homosexuals today.
Gloria a Jesús. Pero la Biblia me dice que eso va a acontecer.
But the Bible has already told us that that was going to happen.
Hay profecías escritas donde dice, Gloria al Señor,
there's
que el anticristo.
There's prophecy spoken that the Antichrist
es un homosexual.
Is a homosexual.
Y como Satanás.
And like the devil.
Ha imitado a Cristo en todas las cosas del Señor Jesús.
He has
imitated.
He has imitated Jesus in everything that he has done.
Gloria a Jesús. El enemigo también está imitando, gloria al Señor.
The enemy is imitating.
Porque antes de que Cristo empezara su ministerio, envió a un mensajero.
Because before Jesus started his ministry, he sent a messenger.
Y antes de que esto acontezca, Satanás ya está preparando el ambiente para enviar el anticristo, gloria a Jesús,
before,
que va a engañar al mundo entero también. Gloria
and just
nombre,
like Jesus sent somebody before him to come to start his ministry, Satan is sending somebody before his things that's going to happen in the world.
Pues está escrito.
Because it's written. He's preparing that person already.
¿Qué tiene que hacer la iglesia?
What? Oh, what does the church have to do?
Prepararse, gloria al nombre del Señor, aleluya. Alabado Dios.
Praise the Lord.
Para que no te coja de sorpresa.
So you will not be surprised.
Pero si todo está escrito, tiene su cumplimiento al pie de la letra.
But if everything is written, everything will be done according to the word.
Porque cielo y tierra pasarán.
Because heaven and earth will pass.
No, su palabra no
but
va
his
pasar.
Word will not pass.
Alabado Dios. Pero Cristo quiere y tiene un pueblo aquí en la tierra que quiere que ese pueblo escape de lo que viene pronto.
But Jesus wants and he has his people to run away from the things that are happening that are going to happen in the world.
Y eso somos tú y yo.
And that is you and I.
Gloria a Jesús. En una de las cartas le prometió a en una de las cartas en la carta de Filadelfia.
In one of the letters to Philadelphia.
Le prometió a aquel pueblo.
He promised that people.
Librarlo de la hora de la prueba que va a venir sobre de los habitantes del mundo entero.
He promised the people that he would liberate them from the hour of time that is coming to those people.
Yo oigo al pueblo que dice Cristo viene pronto.
I hear the people of God saying Jesus is coming soon.
Pero ese pronto puede ser hoy.
But that soon can be today.
Gloria a Jesús.
Praise
en Revelación capítulo 4.
In Revelations 4.
Esa palabra.
That word.
Que está escrita ahí.
That is written there.
Gloria al Señor. Le dijo a Juan.
Told John.
Gloria a Jesús. Escribe las cosas que han de ser después de esta.
Write the things that are after this.
Y eso habla del arrebatamiento de la iglesia.
And that speaks about the rapture of God, of
Gloria
God's people.
Yo no sé si tú estás preparado.
I don't know if you're ready.
Tú sabes cómo estás con Dios.
You know how you are with God.
Gloria al Señor.
Glory
Yo
to God.
Sé, Gloria a Jesús, a través de la palabra del Señor.
I know through the word of God.
Que la Biblia me habla de dos iglesias.
The Bible talks to me about two churches.
Dos iglesias.
Two.
En Mateo 25.
In Matthew 25.
Habla de 10 vírgenes.
Talks about 10 virgins.
10 vírgenes. 5 estaban listas.
5 were ready.
Y 5 estaban aparentemente estaban con lámpara, con aceite, con todo, pero
but 5 they apparently they had their oil, but they were not full.
Eso representa dos iglesias.
Those 10 virgins represent 2 churches.
Una se va,
5. One will go.
Y otra se queda.
And the other one will stay.
¿A cuál tú perteneces?
Which one do you belong to?
Gloria al nombre del Señor. Glory Cristo to God. Viene pronto.
Jesus is coming soon.
Señor, no se tarda mucho, hermano.
God is not going to wait any longer.
Hay mucho pueblo de Dios.
There's too many people of God.
Está debilitándose en la fe.
That is actually debilitating their faith.
Hay mucho pueblo de Dios que está en dos pensamientos.
There is there's too many people of God that are that are double minded.
Gloria al nombre del Señor. Hace unos cuantos años atrás,
a couple years ago,
el Señor habló a mi vida mientras yo estaba en ayuno y en oración en la iglesia.
The church spoke to me while I was fasting and praying in the church.
Y Dios me decía a mí, me hablaba y me decía, ay, qué leyes vendrán que van a afectar a mi pueblo.
He told her, oh, how many laws will come that will affect my church.
Yo estoy viendo eso ahora.
I'm seeing that now.
Gloria a Jesús. Eso hace alrededor de 10 o 12 años atrás.
That was about 10 or 12 years ago.
Pero hace alrededor de 2 o 3 años atrás volvió y me dijo la misma palabra.
But 2 to 3 years ago, he told her again the same message.
Ay, qué leyes vendrán que van a afectar a mi pueblo.
Oh, what laws will come that will affect my people. And a lot.
No están listos.
Are not ready.
No están preparados.
They're not prepared.
Gloria al Señor y se van a ir de la iglesia.
And they will leave the church.
No permitas.
Do not allow it.
El enemigo.
The enemy.
Te turbe la mente.
Will confuse your mind.
Gloria al Señor. Te confunda tu mente.
Will confuse your mind.
Sino que todas estas cosas son para que tú te alinees y vengas al Señor.
Everything you're seeing now that is happening, it is for you to get right with God.
Para escapar de lo que viene, gloria a Jesús.
To escape of what is coming.
Porque lo que viene no es bueno.
Because what's coming is no good.
Cristo quiere que su pueblo salga del mundo.
God wants that his people leaves the world.
Dios te ama.
Jesus loves you.
Dios te ama.
Jesus loves you.
Dios te ama.
Jesus loves you.
Por lo tanto, tienes que salir del mundo para encontrarte con Cristo Jesús en el cielo.
Therefore, you must leave the world to enter the kingdom of heaven.
Alabado sea el nombre del Señor.
Praise
Aleluya.
The Lord, the name of Jesus.
Gloria a Jesús. Dios es real.
God is real.
Gloria a Jesús. Dios puso en este lugar a Eri y a mí.
God put in this church my husband and I.
Gloria a Jesús.
Glory to God.
Y ellos son responsables.
And we are responsible.
De guiarte a ti.
To guide you
por el camino
on the way
que Dios quiere que tú
that
andes.
God wants you to walk.
Alabado Jesús. Porque la iglesia que se va para el cielo,
because the church that will reach heaven,
una iglesia limpia,
it's a church that is
pura,
clean, pure,
sin manchas,
without stain,
sin arruga,
without
porque
wrinkles,
allá arriba,
because up there,
no va a estar el mundo, gloria al nombre del Señor, alabado Jesús. Cristo te ama.
Jesus loves you.
Alabado Dios.
Praise
el Señor está pronto a venir.
Jesus is coming soon.
Yo te digo a ti en esta mañana.
I tell you this morning.
Yo soy un testimonio vivo.
I am a live testimony.
Dios ha hecho muchas cosas conmigo.
God has done a lot of things
yo
with
estoy
me.
En pie por la gracia de Dios y por la misericordia de
I'm
Dios.
I'm standing here for the grace of God and God's mercy.
Yo no puedo casi andar.
She can hardly walk.
Yo no puedo ver.
She cannot see.
Pero le he dicho a Dios,
but I told God,
mi vida está en tus manos. Tómala ya con ella como tú quieras.
My life is in your hands. You do whatever you want with my life.
Alabado Jesús.
Praise the Lord.
Gloria a Dios. Dios me dio el privilegio y la oportunidad.
God has given me the privilege and the opportunity to have 6 children.
Ella es la más pequeña de mis 6 hijos.
I'm the smallest of the 6.
Gloria a Jesús. Y yo sé que Dios tiene algo grande.
And she knows that God has something big with my husband and I.
Gloria al Señor. Porque cuando ellos eran novios, gloria a Dios.
Because when they were boyfriends,
Dios me dijo, yo tengo propósito con los dos.
when we were boyfriends, God told her, I have a purpose for both of them.
No solamente con ellos dos, sino con mis seis hijos.
Not with only us two, but with her six children.
Gloria al Señor.
Glory to God.
Tengo un yerno, gloria al nombre de Jesús.
And I have a son-in-law.
Que ahora mismo
that now
está pasando por una prueba.
He's going through a big trial.
De la noche a la mañana el doctor le dijo, tú tienes cáncer.
From night to day, the doctor told him, you have stage 4 cancer.
Pero yo sé que hay un propósito de Dios, porque
but
Dios
she,
viene pronto a buscar su pueblo, y mis hijos están ahí en ese grupo y tienen que salir de donde están para poder seguirse con Dios.
But she knows that the reason he's going through that trial is because that God is coming soon, and God revealed to my brother-in-law that the reason why he's going through that is because he's bringing her children to God.
Alabado Dios. No sé si tú lo crees, tú lo crees.
If you don't believe it, she believes it.
Esta mañana,
this morning,
cuando me miré al espejo,
when I looked in the mirror,
mi cara hinchada,
my face was swollen.
Mi cuerpo, mi cara, mis ojos igual. ¿Qué es esto, Señor?
She said, wow, what is this, God?
Tuve un sueño malo.
I had a bad dream.
Que donde un hombre con un puñal,
where a man with a big knife
me perseguía para matar.
Would follow her to kill her.
Me levanté, oré.
I woke up, I prayed.
Y le dije, Señor, toma el control.
God, take control.
Yo estoy en tus manos.
I'm in your hands.
Si me muero,
if
I'm
I die,
ready.
I'm ready.
I'm ready.
I'm ready.
I'm, I don't know if you are ready. Hallelujah. I'm ready. We die today. Gloria al nombre de Jesús. Yo me siento lista.
I feel prepared.
Si yo me voy con Cristo hoy.
If I leave God today, if I leave the earth to go with God today.
Pero todavía,
but
no es el tiempo.
But it's not God's timing.
Yo tengo que hacer algo más por Dios.
I have to do one more thing
yo no
for
he
God.
Hecho nada.
I haven't done anything.
Yo no he hecho nada.
I haven't done anything.
Cristo me envió a Santo Domingo.
God sent me to Santo Domingo.
Allí construí un templo.
She was able to plant
yo no
a
he
church.
Hecho nada.
I haven't done anything.
Gloria al nombre de Jesús. Tengo que volver, hace 4 años que no voy.
I have to go back. It's been 4 years since I've been there.
Y tengo que volver a Santo Domingo.
And I have to go back to
a buscar
Santo Domingo.
Aquellas almas metidas en brujería, en santería, en hechicería.
To go look for the people that are in black magic, that are witches and stuff like that that's going on over there.
¿Te lo crees?
Do you believe it?
Cristo lo va a hacer.
Jesus will do it.
Jesús, Dios es Dios.
God is God.
Y él no falla.
He does not fail.
Le he dicho, Dios, mi vida está en tus manos.
I told God, my life is in your hands.
Heme aquí para lo que tú me necesites.
Use me for whatever
hay
you need me.
Hay almas que salvar.
There are souls that need to be saved.
Hay almas que sacarlas de ese mundo perdido, gloria al Señor, y traerlas a los pies de Cristo.
There are souls that need to be taken out from the world to bring
them
for Christ, and that job is yours and mine.
Ese trabajo es tuyo y mío.
That job is yours and mine.
Alabado Dios.
Praise the Lord.
Dios.
God.
Yo no quiero presentarme ante ti con mis manos vacías.
I don't want to show up without. I don't want to show up to you with my hands empty.
Cuando Dios me diga dónde está el talento que te di.
When God asks her, where's the talent that I gave you?
Yo no le voy a decir yo lo escondí.
I don't want to tell him I hid it.
Me diste dos, te doy dos, cuatro más. Gloria
a Dios. If you gave me two, I want to give you four.
Alabado sea el nombre del Señor. La pastora de Santo Domingo me dice, aquí te está esperando una bruja.
The pastor of Santo Domingo told her that over there there's a witch waiting for her.
I don't know para qué.
I don't know for what.
Jesus knows.
Jesus knows.
But I pray for the bruja.
Yes. But she prays for the witch.
I pray for
her. She prays for the witch.
I don't know, maybe I know. I'm sorry. Maybe I know her, I don't know her, but Jesus knows. Gloria a Jesús. I pray for her. Gloria a Jesús. Para que venga a los pies de Cristo.
So he would come, so she would come to Jesus' feet. That is my job.
Dios me preparará.
God will prepare me.
Mi cuerpo.
My body.
Mi salud.
My health.
Necesito mi salud.
I need my health.
Gloria a Jesús, y Dios se encarga de eso.
And God will be in charge of that.
Porque Dios es mi médico por excelencia.
Because he is my doctor in excellence.
Gloria a Jesús. En esta mañana.
In this morning.
Yo no hablo mucho.
I don't talk a lot.
Yo lo que quiero es
all I want to do
que
is
tú entiendas
that you understand
que si yo estoy aquí,
that if I'm here,
es porque Dios me envió a hablar esta palabra.
It's because God sent me to give you this word.
Que cuando yo salga, yo me voy hoy.
Because when she leaves, she goes back home today.
Yo oiga noticia de este pueblo.
I will hear good news about this.
Porque ustedes lo crean o no.
Whether you believe it or not.
I pray for este pueblo.
I pray for this church.
I pray for Eddie.
He prays. She prays for Eddie. For me.
For all the family.
For all the family.
Señor, I know when I'm talking to my God in my intimacy with him. Oh, yes, yes. I speak English. Glory, glory, glory,
glory
to God. Glory to God. Because Jesus coming soon.
Yes.
Maybe I don't see no more you. Maybe I come back to here. But when I come back, I want, you know, make the difference.
Yes.
People.
Yes.
Gloria al nombre del Señor. Dios te bendiga.
God bless you.
Dios te guarde.
God take care of you.
Sigan orando por mi persona.
Keep on praying for me.
Gloria a Jesús. En diciembre pienso ir a Santo Domingo.
In December she will go to Santo Domingo.
Estoy orando por eso.
I'm praying for that.
Para que sea Dios el que me dirija.
That God will be the one who guides me.
Si tú sientes en esta mañana.
If you feel this morning
que Dios te habló a tu vida,
that God has spoken to you,
tú puedes venir al altar.
You can come to the altar. Okay, you can make anew again and say, God, I'm here to do your will. If you're feeling that, God has spoken to you.
Gloria a Jesús.
He just told her, that was for me. Te lo dijo, eso fue para mí. He's telling her that he told her to come for him. And he just walked in the door, not even 10 minutes ago. Am I right?
Gloria a Dios.
Tú acabas de venir a la iglesia o tú estás aquí. Okay. Okay. Ora por él. Who are my catchers and who are my...
Thank you.
Lives are being changed down here. Lives are being changed down here.
Give me reins. Give me reins.
Lives are being changed.
Give me reins.
Nate, give me a little bit more mic.
I don't want
that. Lives are being changed. My mother-in-law, when she prayed for you, it may be in her language, but God hears. Amen. You know, years ago, I've said it to you before, I'll say it to you again, in honor of my pastor, the one who led me to Christ, he said, I would rather offend you and you make it to heaven than not to offend you and you make it to hell. The word is from today, I believe, is Jesus is coming soon. We got to be ready. We got to be ready, guys. Again, the altar is still open. If you don't know if you're quite ready, I'm not saying that you're a rotten sinner. Or, hey, we're all sinners saved by grace. But if there's any inkling that you're not ready, come down and get prayed for before we leave. It's not worth leaving without that assurance. Without that assurance. Hallelujah. Joey, can you? Hallelujah.
Lives are being changed. I can see the faces of lives being changed. Lives carrying burdens. Folks, you don't have to carry any burdens any longer. Just give them to Jesus. Even where you're at, don't be a spectator. Be a participator. Get the burdens off. Give them to Jesus. You don't need to carry that stuff any longer. Get rid of it. Wherever you're sitting, say, God, take it away from me. Anything that may be hindering me from your best, take it, Lord. Take it. Don't carry that baggage around any longer. Hallelujah. Young people down here being prayed for. If you're a young person, a teenager, hey, you need prayer more than any of us. Life's tough for you. Come down and get prayed for. Don't be bashful. Hallelujah. Young man's going into college. You have to make sure that he's strong. Strong in the Lord. Taken away because of diabetes. Wouldn't it be wonderful for a supernatural miracle of a foot being grown out back here today? Why not? It's in the Word of God, is it not? Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Touch woman. Touch woman. Touch woman. You know, one thing that I heard several times in the message was, Jesus loves you. Didn't you hear that echoing through the message? He loves us. He loves us. And because He loves us, He don't want us to miss out on heaven.
That's right.
Because He loves us. Thank you. Thank you, Naomi. Thank you. Being obedient to God today. I want to give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Father God, in Jesus' name, as we go from this place, may we go with the assurance of our salvation. Many came up and they were questioning where they were with God, but today may they leave with the assurance of their salvation. For God, your word declares that it's not in works, but we can boast about it. It's by your grace. It's by your mercy. It's by the faith we place in your Son. the Lord, may we go with the assurance of our salvation. May you put a hedge of protection around each and every one of us. May you fill us with the Holy Ghost, God, in power. And may we leave this place, God, as missionaries on an assignment for you. Going out in the highways and byways of life, telling people about Jesus. Bless these, your people. May they go in peace. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. Greet each other in the Lord.